him that which he requested. Brethren, let your requests be made known unto God. And as we come into his presence, we sing hallelujah, because it's not just because of his blessing towards us, but because we have something to share. Do you have something to share with us this morning?
Lord, it's been so good to me. I too have been down with chickpea. I wet myself and do all the nasty things. But praise God, I'm here today and I'm giving him thanks.
Praise the Lord. We rejoice, brethren and friends. We rejoice because of his blessing. How was the Lord bless you, sister?
The Lord blessed me real good. I was at my home one night and I drop asleep, and when I wake up, I can't do anything for myself.
You couldn't do anything for yourself. Raise your right hand for me.
I can't.
It can't go up, but at least the right foot can move. You can hear, you can walk, you can
talk.
Amen. And you can sing praises to God, and that's just more than enough. Brethren and friends, we rejoice because God has blessed us tremendously, and we just say thank you, Lord. Brethren and friends, today just rejoice in his blessing, because he is God.
Sweet offer, sweet
before you at this moment, in your presence, with humility, we come rejoicing this morning because you are an awesome God. You are the only God. You are the only one who can forgive sins. You are the only one who can heal the sick. I pray, oh God, that as we come before you now, you will cleanse us of all unrighteousness. Oh God, I place myself before you right now. May you remove everything that is unlike you, because I am now interceding on behalf of your people. Almighty God, I pray that you may shower down your blessings upon us. We are here rejoicing. Oh God, may we not just rejoice today, but may we leave here reformed. May we leave here converted. May we leave here with everything in our being a reflection of who you are, who you want us to be. Almighty God, we have issues in this congregation. We have issues in this community. I am sure at this moment that there is an individual, or there are individuals who are hurting. Some individuals do not know what they're going to eat when they leave here. But Almighty God, I pray that whatever food that we have here today for the individuals, it will be food enough for them to continue on their journey. I pray, oh God, as members, that we not forget our purpose here. We are your hands, we are your feet, we are your mouthpiece. So whatever it is that proceedeth from our mouths, may it always be seasoned with salt. May it always be a reflection of you, O Father. As the speaker comes forward to bring us your word, may you cleanse him, O God, because there is absolutely no way you can dwell in a vessel that is not clean and pure. May you touch him now, and whatever it is that he has to say, may touch hearts. May someone's pain be eased today. May we receive and may we experience spiritual growth. Bless us, O Father, and may we all at the end of it all meet you in your kingdom, is my prayer with thanksgiving in Jesus' name. Amen.
Jesus bless, redeem.
My brothers and sisters, we came here this morning rejoicing. And indeed, I don't know about you, but from this morning until now, I have been tremendously blessed. If you have been blessed, your cups have been full and even overflowing, won't you just wave your hands and praise the Lord?
Praise the Lord.
Indeed, we have come here under the theme, we come rejoicing. In his presence, we come rejoicing in his blessings. And from morning until now, we have been rejoicing and worshiping the Lord. We have worshiped him in adoration. We have worshiped him in acclamation. We will worship him in affirmation. But now we seek to worship him in proclamation. Now the one who has been chosen as the medium to declare the word is one who, among his personal philosophies, is a philosophy which says, never take it for granted that something cannot happen because it has never happened before. I believe that is quite instructive. Never take it for granted that something cannot happen because it has never happened before. This young man hails from the parish of St. Elizabeth, the Silo Church, to be specific. And I remember the last time he spoke here, I troubled him. I poked his side because apparently he was missing a rib. But since then, he went out and he remedied that defect, if you recall clearly, for those of you who were here. And we rejoice today that he's here along with his beautiful wife, Stephanie. Is Stephanie in the congregation? Won't you stand at this time? That's Sister Stephanie Taylor. What does the church say?
Amen.
Amen. And certainly there are no children yet, but based on our discussion, that is something which he is aggressively and expeditiously working at. All right? But my brothers and my sisters, the man of whom I speak, yes, is a friend of mine and a friend of ours. He has a passion for the Word of God, a passion for evangelism, a powerful preacher of the Word, and he deeply loves the Lord. He now seeks to stand between us and God, even as we have come rejoicing. He now prepares to stand at this desk and to declare the word of God. But even as he prepares to do so, the masters in Christ will do for us another special musical rendition preparatory to the proclamation of the word by Pastor Everett Tyrone Taylor, E.T. Taylor, pastor of the Lilliput District of Churches. May God bless us as the preacher proclaims his word.
All male group, right? Masters in Christ. Could you give them a better amen than that, man? Amen. By the time I come back to Glendevon, they will be at PhD in Christ, all right? They're at master's level at the moment. Happy Sabbath, everybody. No, man, I think you can do much better than that. Happy Sabbath, everyone. Now you're sounding like Glen Devon. It's good to be here. You did not know, and I hope none of my members are here, but this is my favorite church in Montego Bay. Would you say amen? I want to thank Uncle Charles. He's Pastor Brivett for you, but he's my uncle. Uncle Charles and his team for extending the invitation for me to be here today. I love Uncle Charles with all my heart. And even this morning, I was telling my wife that I love Uncle Charles. He's my favorite presenter. I love to listen to him doing presentations. One of the things I love about Uncle Charles, he's an honest gentleman. He will tell you the truth in front of your face. For him, a hammer is a hammer, a spade is a spade, a backhoe is a backhoe, in front of you, behind you, anywhere at all. And I love him with all my heart. Elder Dockery, thanks for the kind words of introduction. He said that we are friends. That is true, but I'll tell you about the friendship. He only calls me when he needs something from me. And I only call him when I need something from him. But we are friends nevertheless. It's good to be back. I feel comfortable here. I know a lot of individuals here. Brother Miguel, long time we don't see. Sister Harvey, she's not my friend. She's my brethren, all right? Take good care of her. Sister Jennifer McDonald, take good care of her. She's not my friend. She's my brethren. And don't let any mosquito bite them, all right? It's good to be back. Could you open your Bibles with me to the 103rd division of the Psalms, Psalm 103. We will be focusing on verses 1 through to 22. We will skip some verses with the interest of time. I'm going to ask Brother, what's his name now? One of my favorite singers. Brother, what's the first name? Karim, all right? Brother Karim, one of my favorite singers around. Could you come, sir? As the deer panted for the water, so my soul longed after thee. You alone are my heart's desire, and I long to worship thee. You alone are my strength, my shield. To you alone may my spirit yield. You alone are my heart's desire, and I long to worship thee.
As the deer
panted for the water, saints of the living God, sing that song. You alone,
you alone, yes,
are my strength,
are my strength,
my shield. You alone,
you alone,
may my spirit heal. You alone are my heart's desire. Son, you're my friend, and you are my brother.
You're my friend, and you are my brother.
Even though you are a king,
yes,
I love you more than any other. You deserve all praise we can find. Sing that song more than any other. So much more than anything. You search the world and you find none better than God. He loves you with an everlasting love. Sing that song. You alone in days of anguish and pain. You alone in days of having no answer. In days of having no one to look to. You alone. Yes. Does my spirit heal? You alone are my heart's desire.
You alone are my heart.
I long
desire
to worship Thee.
I
could you sing my favorite verse? I want You more than gold or silver.
I want
none of these material things can give us joy and happiness and peace. Only God, sir. Yes. You alone can satisfy. You alone are the real joy giver.
You
may have enough money, but the banks may call you to come and get some. That can't give you happiness. Only in God you can find true happiness, sir. Sing that song, you alone. In days when the devil knocks you on the ground, you alone. In days when you look to your right and in pain, you look to your left and face, you alone. Father, we give Thee thanks. You have been good to us from the day we were conceived in our mother's womb up until this very moment. You have protected us so many times. You have sent Your blessings our way. We give Thee thanks. I ask today that You will rest Your divine hands on my shoulders. You will touch even my sinful lips and made them worthy for the preaching of the gospel. We're thankful the preaching of the word can never be by might nor by power. We're thankful the preaching of the word can never be by intellect nor charisma, but only by Your spirit. And let God's children say, amen. Give me a little bit more cranberry juice in my mic, please. Psalm 103. I talked to you under the caption, the believer's song of thanksgiving. Our theme is, we come rejoicing. And for the divine service aspect, we are focusing on rejoicing over His blessings. The believer's song of thanksgiving. The background of this psalm is unclear. But what is clear is a desire on the part of the writer to praise God for all He has done. He speaks of God's personal blessings in verses 1 through 5. God's national blessings, verses 6 through 7. His forgiving love, verse 8 to 14. His eternal love, verse 15 to 18. And He ends with a universal call for all to praise the Lord. Thanksgiving is a wonderful thing. The child of God has a myriad of reasons for giving thanks every single day. This psalm explores several of those reasons. The psalm was written by David. It was probably written when he was an older man. It contains the language of a man who has experienced the serious consequences of sin and the awesome forgiveness and pardon of Almighty God. Spurgeon, former Britain great preacher, said of this psalm, "As in the lofty Alps, some peaks rise above all others, so among even the inspired Psalms, there are heights of sun of the overtop terrace. This 103rd Psalm, as ever seemed to us, as be the Monte Rosa of the divine chain of mountaintop of praise. You see what Spurgeon is saying, among all the Psalms, Psalm 103 stands out above the rest. Let's spend a little time in this mountaintop of praise as I preach about the believer's song of thanksgiving. There are three P's that we're going to be focusing on. The first one is request. The second one is requirement. And the third one is reasons. The request for thanksgiving. You see, David in this psalm stir up his inner man to praise the Lord. Perhaps he is in a spiritual slump. Perhaps his soul isn't as vocal or as frequent as it should be or used to be. And so he challenges his soul in verse 1. He said, "Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name." Maybe David is drifting from God. Maybe you see David as one who received so many blessings from God. David who had his low moments. David who had his high moments. Maybe he found himself at a stage where as a child of God, he was not praising God as he should. As a servant of God, when he checked what God did for him in the past, he recognized his soul was not thanking God enough for the number of blessings God sent his way. And so he challenged his soul. He's stirring up his soul. He said, "Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name." The word "bless" means to kneel before another in praise and adoration. It is a call for the soul to give adoration. It's a call for the soul to give praise. It's a call for the soul to worship a worthy God. We are living in a day when there is truly a jolt of praise among God's people. You're not hearing me. I said we are living in a day when there is truly a jolt of praise amongst God's people. And sometimes we forget why we come to church. I stop by to tell you that we are just here to praise the Lord. For when the praises go up, the blessings will come down. We are to praise him in the morning. We are to praise him at noontime. We are to praise him in the evening. He deserves our praise, sir. He's still lily of the valley, still rose of Sharon. What a mighty God we serve. David is stirring up his inner soul. He said, "Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name." We would do well to stir up our own souls to praise the Lord today. I heard a song that says, "When I think of the goodness of Jesus and what he has done for me, my soul cries out, hallelujah, thank God for saving me." Billy Bray, one who grew up in Wales in England, he was called the old-time shouter. You see, Billy Bray at one stage was a smoker, at one stage hooked to liquor, and after God's amazing grace saved him, you see, Billy Bray every single day walked up and down in his community saying, "Hallelujah, praise God, hallelujah, praise God," making noise in his community. And the neighborhood, they decided they are tired of this old man walking around saying, "Hallelujah, praise God, we are going to stop him." And they all gathered and came out one day. And while Billy Bray, the old time shouter, was walking around saying, "Hallelujah," on the top of his lungs, "Praise the Lord," they stopped him and said, "Why are you making noise in the neighborhood?" He said, "Listen, man, I can't help it. God has been too good to me. Every time I lift my right foot up, it says hallelujah. Every time I put my left foot down, it says praise the Lord. God is too good." What a mighty God we serve. We praise him for his blessings. We praise him for his mercies. We praise him for his loving kindness. We serve a mighty God.
I jump down to my second R, the requirement for thanksgiving. David warns his soul of the dangers of forgetting the benefits of the Lord in his life. He said in verse 2, bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits. I want you to know the word benefits has the idea of dealings. Don't forget the way God dealt with you in the past. Don't forget, sir, how the Lord has blessed you in the past. Don't forget, lady, all the mighty things that God has done for you. David said, soul, don't forget the ways of Almighty God. He said, soul, don't forget the blessings of God. I find it interesting to know that the word benefits is also the root word for camel. You ask me, preacher, what is this connection? You see, those in the Middle East, camel is a prized possession. They use them to carry loads over long distances, and camels can live for long periods with little food and water. And you see, even in Bible days, a man's wealth was calculated by the number of camels he had. That's why in Job 1 and verse 3, it is listed that Job had certain number of camels. And you see, my brothers and my sisters, the man who enjoys the blessings of God is rich beyond measure, though he may not possess little of this world's treasure. We still ought to praise the Lord. We still ought to bless the Lord. The word forget refers to a lapse of memory that can cause one to wander. And sometimes, because some individuals, materially they are blessed, sometimes we forget what God did for us yesterday. We forget what God did for us last week. We forget what God did for us last month. But David challenged his soul and said, soul, don't forget the blessings of God. Number 334 was a song written by Robert Robinson. This young man was blessed. God showered him with his blessings. Wrote this song while he was in the church. Robert Robinson left the church, wandered back in the world of sin. Left the church, wandered far from a divine God. Left the church, wandered from God's blessing, and went back to material blessing. And while he was living his life out there, traveling on a train one day in America, seated beside an old lady, this old lady started singing hymns. One on the other on the one. And you see, Robert, he sat and he listened and he told the lady, please keep quiet. I don't want you to sing any more songs. And the old lady said, listen, I can't help it. As a matter of fact, I can't stop as yet. I've not done my favorite hymn as yet. And the same song that Robert did and left the church, the lady started singing, come thou fount of every blessing, tune my heart to sing thy grace, streams of mercy never ceasing, calls for song of loudest praise. Teach me ever to adore thee. May I still thy goodness prove, while the hope of endless glory fills my heart with joy and love. And he cried out and said, stop it, don't sing anymore. And the old lady said, I can't stop as yet. I've not done my favorite verse. She started singing the last verse. Oh, to grace, how great a debtor, daily I'm constrained to thee. Let thy goodness, like a fetter, bind me closer still to thee. When she shouted and singing, prone to wander, Lord, I feel it, prone to leave the God I love. Oh, take my heart, take and seal it for thy course above. He broke down in tears when he heard the words of his own song. The same man that God blessed, the same man that was in the church, the same man who wandered from God, when he heard the words, broke down in tears and went back in the church. You can't forget God's blessing, sir. You can't forget God's blessing, lady. David said, bless my soul. I don't want you to forget the blessings of Almighty God. By the way, forgetting is far more than just failing to remember something. The word carries the idea of turning from God to follow other gods. A lapse of spiritual memory will cause the saints to wonder when we forget what we have in Jesus, who we are in Jesus. There is danger that you might wander away from him. Praise keeps us tender. I said praise keeps us clean. I said praise keeps us close. Hear me, my brothers and my sisters. When you don't have any money, still bless God. When you don't have any food, still praise God. When you're health is failing, still praise God. Hear me, even when your marriage is failing, still praise God. When your loved ones pass, still praise God. It's amazing what praises can do in your dark moments. When you go on your knees and cry to God for help, your blessings will come down. When you don't have strength to move on, still find it in your heart to sing praise and glory and thank God for his blessings. And he will change your dark moments. He will change your situations. When the praises go up, the blessings will always come down. And sometimes we allow troubles and trials and anguish to get in the way from praising God. Hear me. Aren't we guilty of allowing our eyes to wander from the Lord? Aren't we guilty of allowing our focus to be man-centered instead of God-centered? Let nothing distract you from praising God. He's worthy. He's worthy. He's worthy to be praised. He's worthy to be praised. And I would remind you this afternoon that while the world is changing, while the church is changing, while your life is changing, the benefits of the Lord never change. Thankfulness is not an option. It is a command. The song says, thanks, thanks, we give thee thanks. I am so blessed. My soul is at rest. Oh Lord, we give thee thanks. Praise is beneficial. It brings peace of heart. It brings peace of mind. It brings contentment. And this leads me to my final R today. Reasons for thanksgiving. We look at requests for thanksgiving, requirements for thanksgiving. We're at reasons for thanksgiving. In this Psalm 130, division of the Psalms, David identifies 8 spiritual reasons that should stimulate our hearts to offer God's thanksgiving and praise, not just in November like America, but every single day of your life, sir. He spoke about God's forgiveness in the first part of verse 3. In him, all sin is gone. Now all our sins, past, present, and future, has been forever put away through the gift of God in Jesus. As a sinner, he forgives me. How could my soul forget that? I say, bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that is within me. The second blessing, God's healing, in the second part of verse 3. In him, the souls are made whole. These bodies we wear are often afflicted with sickness and disease, not just physical sickness, but spiritual sickness like loss and hate and greed and jealousy, discouragement, depression, anger, fear, guilt, and doubt. How could the soul ever forget the tender touch of the great physician as time and again he has diagnosed, treated, and healed our diseases? We have to bless the Lord, oh, our soul, and all that is within me. We have to bless him for his redemption. In verse 4, in him we stand redeemed. Every soul that enters this world is a slave to sin. But thank God for his saving grace. Ellen White says in Step to Christ, as a sinner, we could be the worst person, talking about our justification. The moment we confess our sins, the moment we accept Jesus, she says, God takes the righteous life of his son and places it over our filthy, our dirty records, and he looked at us as individuals who have never sinned, have never failed. I said, redeem. Oh, I love to proclaim it. Redeem by the blood of the Lamb. Redeem through his infinite mercy, his child, and forever. You are redeemed by God's grace. You are transformed by God's grace. You are delivered by God's grace. And that's why we are to praise him. He's a mighty God. We can praise him for his grace. In him, we have received grace, mercy, compassion, salvation, and eternal blessings. His grace is matchless and marvelous. When I think of his grace and his goodness towards me, I have to say, bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that is within me. We praise him for his peace. In verse 5, in him we have been given spiritual satisfaction and sufficient strength for the journey. He does not always give us what we want, but he always gives us what we need. Amidst the misery and the mayhem that is going on, he gives peace that passes all understanding. Different kind of peace from what the world gives. I wonder where the song says, there is a place of quiet rest near to the heart of God. A place where sin, when troubles on your side, God gives peace, sir, that passes all understanding. We can praise him for his intercession. According to verse 6, in him we have one who plead our case. Hear me, sir, every single day. The devil, our enemy, the devil, the accuser, he turns up in the face of God, accusing you, accusing me for the wrongs we have committed. Every single day, he tells God we are not good. Every single day, he tells God we're not worthy. We are a sinner, but we have one who stands between us and God, who just showed the devil his nail prints in his hand and said, listen, this one is mine, redeemed by my blood, sanctified by my blood. He's a sinner, but saved by grace and spirit by mercy. We can always serve the Lord. Something jumps in my head as my friend plays that song a little bit higher for me. Come thou fount of every blessing. When Abraham listened to his wife Sarah, when God told them, even though they were old, that a child would born, and Sarah came up with a perfect idea. I'm too old to have a child. Maybe God wants you to take Hagar and lay with her and bring forth a child. And Abraham listened to his wife, and Isaac, Ishmael came. And you see, the book Patriarchs and Prophets says, the devil went to the gateway of heaven and told God that Abraham is no longer worthy to carry out such a promise. The devil went to the gateway of heaven and told God that Abraham, he failed, because polygamy was not supposed to be practiced among God's people. And God said, listen, I'm going to prove to you that even though he failed, he's still worthy. And that's why he gave him the test of Isaac, the same boy who was supposed to be the promise. And that's why on the third day, when Abraham remained faithful, God said, Abraham, Abraham, don't kill Isaac, for now I know that word in Hebrew is a word called yada, which means relationship. I've proven to the world, I've shown the devil, you are still in a good relationship with me. God, my brothers and my sisters, is always interceding on your behalf. That's a blessing you have to give God thanks for. I know you have failed him in the past, but thank God we have an advocate. His name is Jesus. He's a Savior, his Redeemer, and friend. Second to last, we praise him for his revelation. According to verse 7, in him we can know him, fellowship with him, follow him. He has revealed himself in his word and through his son. And that's why I say, bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that is within me. Finally, we praise him for his sovereignty. In him we can rest in his control over all things. Hear me, sir. He's got the whole world in his hands. In his hands. He's got you and me in his hands. You don't have to fear for the future. Your life is in the hands of Jesus. What God opens, no man can shut. What God shuts, no man can open. He holds you in the hollow palm of his hand. He holds you in his hollow palms of his hand. As David closes this psalm in verses 20 through 22, he calls on all of creation to join him in his praise of the Lord. He called on angels. He called on saints. He called on servants. He called on sinners along with all creation. Are called upon to offer the praise and glory and adoration he deserves. We have only scratched the surface of his blessings. Think of your family. Think of your church. Think of your Bible. Think of your material blessings. Think of your health. Think of your food. Think of your ear. Think of your home. Think about your water. Think about your clothing and your friends. Your blessings are enormous. Our thanksgiving and our praise are to be in direct proportion to our blessings. Hear me, sir. God deserves all the praise we can find in our being. Brother Karim, could you come and sing that song for me? Could you come and sing that song for me today?
As the world
yes.
looks upon me,
yes.
as I struggle,
we have enough to give God thanks for.
Alone.
Yes, sing that song.
They say
sing that song.
Nothing.
They are so wrong.
But they are so
count
wrong.
Count your blessings one by one.
Heart,
come on.
I'm rejoicing.
Wish they could
and
see.
The world fails to see.
Oh, sing that song. Thank you, Lord.
Thank
you, Lord.
You
are good. Thank you, Lord. You are marvelous. Thank you, Lord. You are great. Thank you, Lord. Sing that song.
There's a roof
upon me. He's blessing you right now, sir. He's blessing you right now, lady. He's good. From the sun rises in the east and it shakes hands in the west. God deserves your praise. God deserves your honor. God deserves every fiber in your being, sir. He's good.
You gave me a love, Lord.
Yes, and a fine family. Sing that song.
Above me,
that's a church of
and a good place. I'm in a good place.
Count your blessings. my heart. David said, bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh, that is within me. Bless his holy name. God is good. I know he has been good. That's why we have to do better. That's why we are to praise him. Something jumps in my head, Uncle Charles. Something jumps in my head. I remember the days when I had only one jacket suit. As a ministerial student at MCU, every single Sabbath, you could expect to see me in my one black jacket suit. And Uncle Charles, in those days, I did few evangelistic programs in Comapen and Bull Savannah and Silo and Mount Peace. And you know what I used to have to do? Because I have 5 Sabbaths to preach, and every night in my one jacket suit, sometimes I would not wear it to church. I would just wear my shirt and tie. When it's time to preach, I jump in it, quickly preach a sermon, then I take it off so the brethren don't get too used to it. Sometimes I used to wear it open, and sometimes I wear it closed so the brethren don't get used to it. I remember the days when I had only one. God has been good. Maybe there was a time when some of you could only go to the banks and bank $2,000 and $3,000. But some of you now can go to the bank and bank $100,000, $200,000, $500,000. God has blessed his people. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that is within me. Come thou fount, is a song I'm going to use. I have 2 calls today. As Uncle Charles is coming, I have 2 calls today. You are here, not yet a baptized member of the church, but you know that God has been good to you. He's the one who wake you up every single morning. He protects you while you're traveling on the road. You are not yet a baptized member of the church. I want to pray with you at the altar today. Come down front of every blessing. I want to pray with you down front today. I have 2 simple calls. You know that God has been good to you. Though you are not yet baptized, though you are not yet in the church, you can count your blessings. You have seen God's miraculous work in your life. And today you want to say, thank you, Lord. Are you coming? You are not yet a baptized member of the church. I want to pray with you down front. Walk from where you are. As my friends sing that song, 334. Come, thou fount of every blessing. Uncle Charles is coming. We don't have much time. I see you come. Hear me, sir. The devil could have killed you many times. God spared your life. Hear me. The food you put on your table, God is providing it. You can't bear ackee. You can't bear yam. You can't bear oranges. You can't bear mango. God is good. And we say, bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that is within me. I say, you come. You are not yet on the side of God, but you want to show your gratitude. You want to show your appreciation. You want to show that, God, you have been too good for me to neglect you. You have been too good for me to ignore you. Walk from your seat. Make your way down front. Sing that song. Yes. Yes. Ever. For thee, may I still my goodness prove. Yes, while the hope of endless glory fills my heart. I see you come. I know you are standing somewhere. Maybe you're on my right, standing, not yet a baptized member of the church. God's blessings have covered your soul. God's blessings have enveloped your life. God's blessings are walking with you. Challenge you, come today and show glory to God. Maybe you're on my left. I know God has been good. I know God has delivered.
Wandering for the phone of rescue
from danger.
Before
they sing the last verse. Before they sing the last verse. You're a baptized member of the church, but today you want to start counting your blessings.
one by one. You want to show gratitude. You want to show appreciation to the goodness and the mercy and all the blessings that God has wrought in your life. And you want to show that by pressing a little to come towards the front as they sing that third verse. Before Uncle Charles pray, God, I know, sir, has been good, and you can bless the Lord today. Oh, my soul, all that is within me. Won't you sing that verse?
Oh, to grace, how great a measure.
Healing!
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 Yes!
And I know.
Like a feather!
Like a feather!
Hide me closer!
Hide me closer!
Still to thee! Closer still to thee! Prone to wander! We praise Him for His blessings. We praise Him for His love. We praise Him for His loving kindness. Hallelujah! He has been good. Bless the Lord, sir. Bless the Lord, lady. Bless the Lord. Oh, my soul. The Lord is with me. Bless His holy name.
Lord and our Heavenly Father, this for us is a day of thanksgiving. Our blessings and benefits are not the same, but in unison we respond to all your lavish blessings in our lives, and we say, bless the Lord, O my soul. We recognize that you have taken us thus far. For some of us, you have taken us a mighty long way. Some of us, you have catapulted us from poverty into comfort. Bless the Lord, O my soul. Some of us have been moved from ignorance to knowledge, degrees and certificates and diplomas. Bless the Lord, O my soul. Some of us, you have moved us from country to town, given us some of us visa and green card. Bless the Lord, O my soul. Some of us have struggled with our children. Now they have achieved and they are established and can make our lives better. Bless the Lord, O my soul. Some of us were pedestrians walking untold miles. Now we have a key in our waist or in our pockets and a vehicle in the parking lot. Bless the Lord, O my soul. Some of our parents were never known by the bank. Many of us are known and can be called by first name. Some of us have substance in the bank. Bless the Lord, O my soul. You have moved some of us from the gutters of sin and degradation. Folk never expected much of us. Never expected us to last long in the church. Some of us are ordained as deacons and elders and pastors. Bless the Lord, O my soul. Many are struggling to make ends meet. They reach out to you as the bread of life, and they bless you. Many don't know what tomorrow holds, but they know that you hold tomorrow, and they ask you to hold their hands. Thank you for those with talents who have lifted us to heavenly places today. Thank you for those who have come to the altar wanting to express their gratitude and wanting a closer walk with you. Lord, our hearts transcend the boundaries of the timeline of this program, and we look forward to the day when the redeemed from the earth shall break forth in songs of joy and gladness and rapturous thanksgiving, and when sinners redeemed by your grace shall raise the song of victory, that angels will fold their wings, for angels have never felt the joy that our salvation brings. Keep us faithful till that day, Lord. This is not even dress rehearsal. This is only our imagination running wild. But when the reality is cast in kingdom come, help us to be there to embrace you and cast ourselves down at your feet and bless the Lord, oh my soul. We pray that your blessings will rest, remain, and abide with us as we break for the refreshing of the physical food. We pray that you will bless it too, and as we partake, make us a channel of blessing to others, and bring us back this afternoon for the enrichment of the evening's program. Thank you for Pastor Taylor and the word that he has delivered. Keep him strong and faithful and vibrant, and use him to glorify your name and hasten your coming, for Jesus' sake. Amen. Amen. Please be seated, my friends. It is.